How to import and export LUT files, lookup table files in DaVinci Resolve. Let's see how it's done. Now as you can see in my timeline, I've got this footage and this is a color graded footage. If I go to the media pool, as you can see, this is the raw footage. If I go to the color tab down here and go to the notes and click on this note and press Ctrl D on my keyboard, you can see that this is the raw footage and this is the color graded footage. Now, first thing, let's see how you can export a LUT. All you have to do is go to the clip section right here and right click on the clip that you have color graded, go to generate LUT and you'll see three options: 17 point cube, 33 point cube and 65 point cube. Let me explain what these are. 17 point cube is basically a very lightweight file that will get generated, but also you won't get as much details as you want in the LUT. So 17 point cube is a light file and lesser details. Then comes 65 point cube. Now this will be a much heavier file and you'll get lots of details. It will be detail heavy as well as size heavy. So a bigger file as well as lots of details. And then there's 33 point cube, which is a perfect balance between both of them, details as well as performance. So you'll get enough amount of details in the colors and the file size will also be perfect. So we're gonna go ahead with 33 point cube. And first, before exporting, what you have to do is, instead of clicking on it directly, go to the LUTs tab right here, right click on LUTs and go to open file location. Once you've opened it, simply create a folder. I'll create a new folder and name it test. Okay, hit enter, then go to test and just copy this location. Then go back to the DaVinci Resolve and here, then right click on the clip, go to generate LUT, go to 33 point cube and then paste the location here, hit enter and then name your cube file whatever you want. I'm gonna name it Sam and hit save. Now all you have to do is right click on LUTs and hit refresh. If you scroll below, as you can see, test is here and we've got Sam raw. So that's how you can export a LUT file in DaVinci Resolve. Now let's see how you can import it. First thing that we are going to do is, I'm going to go to the edit tab and drag in the raw clip again, right? So this is the color graded footage and this is the raw footage. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to drag and drop in the LUT on this raw footage and see if both look the same. So we're going to go to the color tab and here we've got the raw footage now. All you have to do is apply the LUT to this footage. There's three ways to do it. First is simply double click on it, it'll get applied. Then you can drag and drop it on it. Third way is right click on it, go to LUT and then go to test and then click on Sam. So those are the three ways. Now I applied the LUT to it and let's check if both are the same. So if I click on this and this, see, both look exactly the same. There's absolutely no difference at all. So we have successfully applied the LUT as well. So we've exported and imported the LUT in the DaVinci Resolve. Now one last important thing to note is that LUT files don't always carry every single detail that you're gonna edit in DaVinci Resolve. There's a few limitations to LUT files as well. If you open a LUT file, let me show you, right click on it, open file location. If I open it, it's basically a lot of calculations and data, right? So it can only hold a certain amount of things. So when you go to the color tab and apply all kinds of effects, not all will be stored in the LUT file. So there's a few LUT friendly effects and non-friendly effects. Now on your screen, you're gonna see the LUT friendly effects as well as the non-friendly effects. And all you have to do is not expect the non-friendly effects to be there in the LUT file. Only the friendly ones will get applied. So that's pretty much it for the video, guys. That's how you can import and export LUTs in DaVinci Resolve. I hope you find this video useful. And if you do, make sure you like this video. It really helps the algorithm suggest this video to the needful people. Also, share this video with your friends and consider subscribing to the channel. I post such video editing tutorials, how to tech videos, tech reviews, I stream games occasionally, and I post some knowledgeable and informative YouTube shorts. And that brings us to the end of the video, guys. Thank you for watching the video. I'll see you all next time. Bye bye.